This conference will now be recorded.
So in this session, in the last session, we have discussed about the aggregations, right? Aggregations, okay. In this session, we shall try to discuss the same aggregation operations on pair RDDs, guys. We call them as pair RDD. Okay, so we shall see what a pair RDD is and what aggregation operations can be done on this pair RDDs, and how these aggregations and pair RDDs behave differently from that of normal aggregation operations. Let's try to understand all those, okay, whether these are transformations or actions. Okay, last session whatever we have discussed the aggregations like reduce and the fold, aggregate. So these operations, all these operations are actions. Okay, these are not transformations, these are all the actions. Now we are going to discuss this pair RDD operations, whether these are going to be transformations or actions and how they behave different from that of the above three aggregations operations. Let's try to understand all this. Okay, fine. Okay, so here how do we define a pair RDD? Is an RDD, remember, an RDD in which element, in which each record, or in which each record is an ordered pair, or simply is a pair of elements, is a pair of elements in it. Okay, in which every record, every record is a pair of elements. Pair in the sense, you know how that will be represented, pair, an element, a record, something like say comma b, where a is an element, b is an element. Okay, this is of the form a comma b. So if an RDD has the records of the form in this form, okay, as a pair a comma b, where a is an element, b is an element, they can be integers or they can be strings or they can be of any data type, but a record must be of the type like this, a pair. Okay, such RDDs will be called as pair RDDs. Okay, and in this pair RDD, in this pair RDD a comma, in the in each record a comma b, by default Spark can assume, Spark will consider a as key and b as value. Okay, if we have these elements of this form like a comma b as a pair, directly Spark will understand that, Spark understands that the first element is key and second element is value. Okay, based on the only we have certain operations directly we can do with Spark on these records. Okay, let's try to see that, and let's try to create certain a simple pair RDD, and let's try to perform some operations. Okay, let's do that. Now here I will try to create a simple RDD, RD1 equal to Spark dot Spark context dot parallelize of, let me create one pair RDD. So if a record has to be pair RDD, then first I will create one list equal to if I say something like this, a comma 10, let's say second element some b comma 20, and let's say c comma some 15, next d comma some 25, and next again a comma some 30, and b comma 26 and c comma 10. And finally, I will create one more element of a comma sum 10. How many we have created? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let me get one more last. Sum d. D to be sum 10 again. Fine. Okay. This is one list we have created. And with this list, we are trying to create one RDD. RD1 equal to spark dot spark context of parallelize. Okay. And let me just print this. Print RD1 dot collect. And let me run this first. Let me run this once. So it has to print the all these elements. Okay. Totally 1, 2, 9. How come C is printed as without braces here? Did we miss anything? Yeah. We missed the brace here, comma here. Did you miss anything? D25.
Sir, 15. You want C15. No,
yeah,
remove the comma.
Yeah. Got it. It's fine. Now let's see the number of partitions of this. Get num partitions. Number of partitions is one, but for our discussion we require at least two partitions, so let's go with at least two partitions. Why? Because we are going to perform some aggregations, it requires two or at least three partitions. So to understand the concept, that's what I'm going with three. Okay, fine. Now after this, let me try to print the records in each partition, how the records are distributed into each partition. We have three partitions, and how the records got distributed into each partition. Let's try to print them also. Okay, EF1 of some x colon yield list of x. This I'm trying to print all those as a list. Okay, fine. Next, some RD2 equal to RD1 dot, what is the function to display the partitions? Map partitions. Okay, map partitions lambda of x and f1 of x, and print RD2 dot collect. Yeah, you can see, guys, this is how the data distributed into the partitions. The first partition we have three elements, and second partition we have three elements, and the third partition we have three elements. That is three records. Totally nine records are distributed into three partitions uniformly. Is it fine? Okay, so let's go with RD2. RD is not required. We are going with RD1 only. Just with RD2 we are printing the data, that's it. Okay, now what is that we have to do is we should try to perform certain operations. Okay, now in this, if I want to find you know what, I will use one operation and I will ask that question. Okay, fine. Now I read something like this. Sum R1 equal to RD1 dot reduce by, or before this, count by key, print R1 dot collect. Can you tell me, guys, what is going to be the result of this? RD1 dot count by key. So here we have these records, A, B20, all this. So which is going to be taken as a key and which is going to be taken as a value here? Simply, we are trying to apply a function called as count by key, and what it is going to return. So as I said you just now, when we have a pair like this, the first element of the pair A will be here, the by default it will be taken as like it will be considered as key, and second the B element B is considered as value. So in this, in every record, the first element is considered as key, A, B, C, all this. Okay, B, C, D, A, B, C, A, B, A, D. And 20, 10, 20, 15, 25, all this is considered as values. So we are trying to apply count by key. Let's see what is going to be the output of this. What is this? Collections dist has no object. Okay, let me just print out one. You can see this guys here, A3, C2, B2 and D2. What does this mean? What's happening here? How many pairs are there, or how many records are there where the key is A? You can see here. And how many records are there with key C? How many are with B? How many records are there with key D, with D as the key? So count by key. So it is counting how many records are there based on the key. Got it? Is it fine, guys? Okay. And similarly, there is a function called as count by value. I think count by value. Now let me print this R2. We have a look at this. If we have a look at this, see this guys here, RD1 count by key, that's fine. Next, RD1 count by value. What's happening? Just observe here. So there is only one record, D10, it is only one record, B20, it is only one record, and C10, it is only one record, and D25, all one records. But you observe here, A, 10, it has two records. There are two records. A, 10 are is of two instances. Okay, it has occurred two times in the RDD. So it is counting the number of records, the number of records that are present in the RDD. We count by value and count by key. So we have these functions ready-madely in Spark. We need not to do anything for this. Simply, it is going to find out how many keys, how many values, how many records are going to be there in the RDD. Okay, just based on this, now we are going to perform certain operations called as aggregation operations. Before this, I will let me show you one more operation that is called as R3 equal to RD1 dot happen. Order, we should have order, I think not order, we have sort by key, I think sort by key. Can you guess guys what would be the output of this? No, you can guess easily. R3, what would be the output of this? Sort by key, the keys are A, B, C, D here.
It will be same like count by key.
Let's see that. It's RDD, right? RDD in the sense we need to apply collect here. Just see what happened here. Key, and here we have A, B, C, D, right? So when we try to sort by in alphabetical, the data is going to be ordered or sorted in alphabetical order. You can see this. All the records of A has come first. A, 10, 30, 10. And B, next all Bs. Next all Cs, followed by all Ds. Okay, so the data will be ordered, will be sorted based on the keys, that is in the alphabetical order. If the keys are integers, If the keys are integers or any other number, float or anything, they will be sorted based on those values. Okay, as the keys are a string characters here, they will be ordered based on the alphabetical order, okay, in the chronological order. Okay, is it fine? Those are simple operations, count by key, count by value, sort by key, that's it. If you want to sort the elements, this is going to be a very useful option actually. Okay.
Fine. Is there any option ascending or descending? No, right?
Ascending, no, we hold like that. Ascending, descending, no. You large amounts of in Spark, we are not going to arrange them in ascending or descending order.
Okay,
that's
right,
what I told you. Remember, guys, here there's a question here actually. Here, Spark supports, there are actually two types of operation that can be done on data. Okay, two types of operations, remember. One is called as coarse-grained operations. Generally, if you have some data in real world, what type of operations are supported? Generally, there are two types of operations. One is coarse-grained and another is fine-grained. Do you know what is the difference between these two? Coarse-grained operations and fine-grained operations. See here. The RDBMS operations, whatever the operations we perform in real time, simply the RDBMS operations like bank accounts, such type of operation called as come under fine grained. Let's say we have some 1 lakh customers. Let's say if a bank has 1 lakh customers, is it possible to update any one customer record? Is it possible or not? I'm a customer of the bank, that
yes.
Bank has 1 lakh customers. I have deposited some amount into my account. Will my account get updated, or does it depend on other records or other customers' data? It doesn't depend, right? It gets updated. That means graining. We can do the graining finely. That is, any record or any account, anything can be updated at any point of time. It is allowed. But coming to Spark, this fine grained is not supported. Why? Because large amounts of data will be there. So trying to update, trying to modify, trying to delete only one record, only one field, such kind of operations are not allowed. If you want to do something, do it in bulk. If you want to do some operation, do it in bulk. That's it. Okay. Like the operations, you know what? Let's say there are 1 lakh employees in our company. I would like to give a hike of, let's say, some 15% to each employee. Now, this operation is common to everyone. This operation is common to everyone. It is not fine-grained, just type of called as coarse-grained. Such type of operations we can do with Spark, but not fine-grained. Only particular records, only particular fields, such type of operations are not allowed. Not allowed, not supported actually. Why? Because it is going to, why? Because Spark doesn't maintain the order of the data. That is the first thing. Okay. And in RDBMS, every record is identified with a unique ID, right? The primary key. Because there is a primary key. But we don't have the concept of primary key, secondary key here. So such type of operations, that is identifying a particular record. So in RDBMS, how do we identify a particular record? By its primary key, right? But in Spark, we don't have anything, something called as primary key. So only bulk operations are supported. Only they will be applied on the Spark. Remember that point. Is it okay? Fine. Now, let's try to perform some operations. Let me clear all the outputs. This time, muting all this. Okay, fine. Next, I'll print RD2. It is not good. RD1 only. Better to print RD2 only, because we'll have. Right. Now we are going to perform some operations, which are called as aggregation operations. I call it first reduce by key. I call it as some S1 equal to RD1. This is RD1 only, guys. Okay, this is the input here. RD2 is just the map partition. That's it. Okay, RD1 dot reduce by key. Oh, I'm writing like this. We shall discuss what will happen with this. Already we have seen the functionality of this reduce by key in what you call as word count program implementation, word count application implementation. Okay, now we will print s1 dot collect, otherwise just print s1. So here we are printing rd2 and as well we are printing s1. So rd1 data is printed like this, and intentionally I did not use collect here s1. So as I said you here, this reduce, fold, aggregate, they were actions, right? They were actions. Okay, but here if you have a look at this reduce by key, it is not an action, it is a transformation, because of which it is returning an RDD. Okay, RD1 is a RDD, and that we are applying the transformation reduce by key, so it is returning one more RDD. So this must be a transformation. Okay, it is returning Python RDD, this RDD. So if you want to display the output of RDD, we use this operation, right? Collect. Now you will get the data, whatever that we have in this output. Now we got the result, guys. Here, this is the result actually. This entire record. Okay. See what happened here. What is that happened? Here we got as 46. So how many distinct keys are there here? Four distinct keys, right? We have four distinct keys here. A, B, C, D. So for each key, so all the records, I'm telling you, all the records which have the same key will be grouped first. I'm repeating the statement, just make a note of this part, guys. All the records which have the same key will be grouped first. Okay, so write down here the first two. What happens with reduce by key or the aggregation that we perform on pair RDs? Okay, all the records of RDD with same key will be grouped first. Grouped, that means grouped in the sense they will be brought together. Okay, all the records which have the same key will be grouped first, that is they will be brought together. After that what is happening, whatever the function that we are specifying here, okay, whatever the function that we specify here, this function will be applied, applied on what? Applied on the values of the grouped items. Grouped records are items, okay, whatever you call it as. So all the records are items of ord with the same key will be grouped first, then function will be applied, the function that we specify in the aggregation will be applied on the values of the grouped items. Okay, here we have these elements. Let me copy and paste this. Copy. So these are the elements A10, B20, and all this. We have these records. Now what should happen with reduce by key is the first step. All the records with the same key will be grouped first. What are all the records here? A10 is one record, and we have one more with A. What is that? A30 is there. B comma 30 is there, and we have one more record with A, A10. You can see here, A10, A30, and A10. Totally three records, and second record. Second grouping will be done based on the second one more key, B comma 20, followed by next to B comma 26, and that's it. Okay, and 3C, all the records which are having C, where is C 15 and C 10. I think we have only two. Next comes to D. D has 25 and sorry, D25 and D10. Okay, the data is going to be grouped first. Okay, but this is not correct one, guys. And let me show you that. Okay, this is one. And finally, what is the second one I have seen here? That function, whatever the function that we have specified, that function will be applied on the grouped items. So it will be, it has to be done like this, a comma. What is the function that we have specified here? X comma y, lambda of x comma y, x plus y. That means these values will be added. 10 plus 30, we get some result, right? Again, the result will be added to 10. Okay, and here b comma 20 plus 26, we are going to get this result. So correspondingly, what we have to get here for a, what is the value we have to get? A comma 30, for a 50, b 46, c 25 and d 35. Okay, just to see here, a 50 you got here, okay, and b 46, c 25 and D 35. This is the result we got. Do you think, is it the correct one? Do you think, is it the correct one or not? Correct approach. Hello? Guys, are you there?
Hello?
Yeah, are you there, guys? Yeah, we are fine. Yeah. Now, if we think this is the correct approach, so we are getting the result correctly. Now let's do one thing. What I do is I perform subtraction of this. Let me call this as S2. S2 dot collect. Okay, now according to this, if we perform subtraction, what should be the output, guys? Let's see, if we perform subtraction, what is the output for A? Can you tell me?
Minus 30.
10 minus 30, minus 10. Okay, yeah. So that has to be minus 30, isn't it? And for this, if it were performing subtraction, b comma 20 minus 26, it has to be minus 6. And for c, the addition should be 25, and subtraction should be 15 minus 10, that would be 5, isn't it? And for d, sum has to be b comma 35, and subtraction should be d comma 15. Yeah, right. But let's see whether we got the same results or not. A minus 30, b minus 6. A minus 30, b minus 6. C5 d 15. Do we get the same result? Did you get the same result? Yeah. Now let us run once again. We're getting the same result, that's fine, but actually this is not what that is going to happen internally. This is not what is that is going to happen internally. What is going to happen is, whatever we have seen, everything is perfect here. Everything is perfect. All the records will be grouped first, and all the function will operate on the values of the group. That is fine, but this will be done, the grouping of data will be done for each partition first. On each partition, I'm telling you, on each partition. Let's say P1 is the first partition and P2 is the second partition and P3 the third partition. What are the records we have in the first partition here? These three records, right? A10, B20 and C15. Let me write in separate lines. In second, 1 second. P1 first partition. Yeah. This is the data of first partition. Data of second partition. This is the data of second partition. And this is the data of the third partition. I think we have one more record here. P3 and these records. Okay. So here the first thing is the data will be grouped. The data will be grouped. There's no doubt in that. But depending upon you know what, in the partitions the data will be grouped first. After that, the data is grouped based on the results of the partitions. Let me simply explain that. So why we are getting the same result is, I will show something like this. 1 second. What I have to do is, let me do one thing here. L1, what I do is A, B, C, A, your vertex C. So I'm just changing the L1 value here, the data I'm changing. Let me once execute that. Yeah, perfect. Now, just I change the records guys here, 10, 20, 15, A 25, A 30. I change this to A here, 25 to A 30. And one more, what is the one I have changed? B 26, C and A comma C. And this also I have changed to C. Now, can you tell me what would be the result here? Less than subtraction, addition and subtraction. A, 10 is a 25. We need to add one more record here. That is A 25. So what is that we are going to get? Plus 25. And C, we have added one. We have deleted D. What is that we have deleted here? 24, I think D we have deleted totally. What is that we have? C 10. We have added one more here, that is called as C 10. Is it fine? Just to go through this guys, C 35. I think we don't have D any D records here. Do we have any D records here? Just observe in this. Why? Because to understand this one, we need to just focus on this, guys. That's why I removed D, to understand actually the purpose of the working for style of this function. So we have A, B, C only these records. Okay, only these records. Now can you tell me A 20, 30, 10, 9, 25 and A, what is the subtraction here? Subtraction is going to give 10 minus 30 minus 20 minus 20 minus 10 minus 30 minus 30 minus 25 minus minus 30 minus minus 55. And B, what is subtraction value of B? 20 minus 20, it will be 6 only. C, 15 minus 10, 5. 5 minus 10, it has to be minus 5, isn't it? And d, we don't have d here, no, just delete this d. So this has to be the result for subtraction: a minus 55, b minus 6, c minus 5. Is it correct, guys? Just can you see this? For addition, what we have to get here? Can you tell me for addition what we have to get? 10, 40, 50, and 75. This must be 75. And for addition, it must be 46. And for this here, we have to get 15 plus 10, 25. Yeah, it is 35 only. Fine. So for addition, we have to get 75, 46, and 35. Did we get the same result? Just verify here. 75, 46, 35. Addition we got correctly. But coming to subtraction here, here the results are 55, 6, and minus 6, and minus 5. If you observe here, what did we get? We did not get what you call as minus 55 here. Instead, we got only 5 here. And B is minus 6. What is that we got? B? Yeah, B correctly we got. And C has to be minus 5. But what is that we got for C? C for C, we got it as 15. Why it is different here? If this is the logic, if this is the approach, if this approach is correct, what do you think that's happening here? And what is the reason for it? Can you tell me?
Order in which the things are taken is different.
Yeah, so the order is missing, right? So if the addition is working fine, the subtraction also work fine. So, but the order is missing. Why the order is missing here? Why do you think that is missing? Okay, so here
partitions may have different data.
Yes, yes, perfect. The thing is, yeah, here the data is getting grouped. That's fine, 100% correct. Whatever that we have written, two statements, they're 100% correct. There is no wrong in it. But the only thing is, the data will be grouped within the partitions, not globally. Okay, the data will be first grouped within the partitions, later they will be grouped globally. Remember that point. Okay, the records will be grouped first internally in the partitions, later they will be grouped globally. Global in the sense across all the partitions. Okay, that is what that is going to happen first. Okay, so in the first partition, what is the records? We have A10, B20, C15. That's fine. In the second partition, we got A25. That is right. A25, A30, B26. A30, B26. In the second one, C10, A10, and again C here, C10. So these are the partitions data. First, the data will be grouped within the partitions. The data will be grouped within the partitions. So do we have any key repeated here? Do we have any key repeated? The three records are different, right? The three keys are different, A, B, and C. So they will be as it is. No grouping required. Why? Because the data is as it is. That is, no key is repeated. But if you come to the second one here, second partition, here we have two occurrences of A. So now it is going to be something like A comma 25 and another one 30, next followed by B 26. This is how the data will be grouped within the partitions first. Okay, and after this we have C here. Now first the data will be grouped based on the key C. For C, we have 10 and 10 again here, one more 10. And for A, we have only one, that is 10. This is how the data will be grouped first, I'm telling you. Okay, fine. Now, what will be the result of this? What will be the result of the first partition data? That will be same. Because there's no grouping, the data will be as it is. This is going to be the result. This is going to be the same result. Okay, but when we come here, the second partition here, the addition, whatever the operation we are specifying here, plus or minus, let's go with minus here, x minus y, that will be done, that will be executed between these results, these values first, A25 and B30. So correspondingly, we get the result as A comma 25 minus 30 minus 5, and B 26. Got it? And next, corresponding to the third partition, C. Firstly, what is the result? C 10 minus 10. That would be simply 0, comma, and A, comma, 10. This is the data, guys. This is the results of the partitions. Okay, in what happened here, it is first in the part within the partition, the data is grouped. The data in the sense the records are grouped based on the key. Okay, if within the partitions, first the records will be grouped based on the key, and the operation will be applied on the grouped items. Grouped in the sense 25 and 30 are grouped here. So what is the operation that is getting performed on them? Whatever that we have specified in the function. Okay, so first within the partitions. So I have to write like this first. So within the partitions, all the records will be grouped first with the same key. Okay, and function will be applied on the grouped items. So this is done. So we have finished that. Whatever we have written, that is finished. So within the partition, all the records are grouped based on the key, and the function will be applied on the grouped items. That's fine. Still is not yet done. Now the work that has to be done within the partitions is over. The work that has to be done within the partitions is completed. That is grouping and applying the function on the group data, that is done. Now the same thing has to be done. The same two steps must be repeated outside the partition, that is across the partitions. Okay, now see here. Now in the first partition, we have A, B and C. Okay, and in the second partition also we have A and B. In the third partition, we have C. Now come to the first partition. In the first partition, we have A is 10. Do we have any other record with A as the key in other partitions? Yes, we have, right? We have in the second partition. Second partition, we have A equal to minus 5. So that will be grouped again. Comma, minus 5. And we have one more record of A in third partition. A is 10, so that will be taken here. So this is the grouping, that is grouping of the records across the partitions. Okay, not within the partitions, across the partitions. This coming to B, do we have any instance of B? In the first partition we have 20, and the second partition we have 26, and third partition we have, no, we don't have any, we have only 2. And coming to C, comma, in the first partition we have 15, second partition no, and third partition 0. Okay, so corresponding to this, now the data is grouped across the partitions based on the key. Now the function will be applied on them. So A comma 10 minus minus 5, what is the result? 10 minus minus 5, 15, right? Minus of minus 5, that is going to be plus. 15 minus 10 is going to be 5. This one, B comma 20 minus 6, minus 6, sorry, and C, this will be equal to 15 minus 0, that is going to be 15. That's it, right? So A5, whatever the result we got here, A minus 55, the result is different now. Okay, you can see here, with previous approach we got as A minus 55, but now we got as A equal to 5. B minus 6, that's fine. C equal to minus 5, but here we got C equal to 15. Now this has to be the correct result. 5 minus 6, 15. Let's verify that. We can see here, 5 minus 6, 15. That's it. Got it, guys, here? Okay, do you have any questions on this, guys? It's very simple, guys. The records will be grouped and function will be applied. The records will be grouped based on the key. That's the first step. And function will be applied on the on the grouped item. That is well the second step. But that will be done at two levels. that will be done at two levels. One is within the partitions and second is across the partitions. Okay, this is the one. So first step one or level one, I call it as level one, that is within the partitions. This is a step one and this is the step two. Okay, now copy and paste it. Okay, so this is a level two, not within the partitions, across the partitions, and that's it. Everything is same. So these are the two things that are going to happen. Is it clear, guys? Any questions? Do you have any questions here? In understanding this, in knowing, do you have, if you have any questions or any doubts, please let me know. Yeah, Narendra, Ramesh, Hari, Kiran, Shravanti, Sweta.
No questions, sir. It's clear. Yeah.
It's very simple class. It's very simple. Only thing is, how Spark will perform, you know, operations. General first word is, if you want to, if it has to do some operation, first it will perform on the partitions at the partition level. Later it will perform at the results of the partitions level across the partition. That is it. Very, very simple. Any operation that is going to be same. Okay, it's very, very simple. Here also, now, 1 second. Now, let me run this code again. Yeah, get some result. Now let's go with the next operation that is called as fold by key. This is operation is reduce by key, and the next one is fold by key. So what is the syntax of this reduce by key? Is reduce by key, that is very simple. There is only simply function. I am calling it as function. That's it. What are the function we are writing here? No, that replace that with f1. That's it. Very simple. Okay. Second one is fold by key. Fold by key of zero value and function. We write like this: zero value and function. Fold by key. Like we have zero value in the previous class, we have discussed about it, right? That's it. Okay. And next we have what is it called as? Aggregate by key. So zero value, here zero value comma two functions. We'll have two functions. Okay, and here we have one more, combined by key. So zero value will be there, function one, function two, function three. Three functions will be there in the combined by key. So it would be some, we need to spend some time to understand combined by key. Why? Because there we have three functions. Three functions, so we need to understand what is the purpose of all these, each function. Then only we can understand what combined by key. Okay, not a problem, we'll understand. It's only because, but we need to spend some time on that. But before that, we shall try to see how fold by key behaves and how aggregate by key behaves. So already we have seen in the last session, what is the difference between fold and aggregate? Okay, and what is the use of this zero value? Let's try to see the syntax of it and let's try to see the output of it. Just I'm clearing all this. Fine. Now, on the same RD1, I perform the same operations. Sum S3 equal to RD1 dot fold by key. So zero value sum, I take it as 2, I can write the function directly, x comma y. So then x plus y. And print s3 comma, so not s3 comma, s3 dot collect. And one more point guys here, is this reduced by key? What is happening here? You know, the data is going to be grouped. So what do you think that will happen between the partitions? What do you think that will happen between the partitions? Does it involve shuffling of data? Yes, shuffling, right? So obviously it has to go with what? A new stage. Whenever we perform reduce by key, a new stage has to be created. Okay, let's see that. I think this was the latest one. Let's see that. Let's click on this. I think this must be reduce by key only. Yeah, reduce by key. So it is going to internally involve shuffling operation. Okay, remember that all these grouping operations, whatever I have mentioned here, all these are going to involve grouping. So grouping involves moving of data from one node to another node, that is one partition under partition. So all these are wide transformations only. Okay, the transformations and all these are wide transformations. Okay, remember that point. So these are let me write this. All these are Y transformations. That's it. Okay, fine. Now let's go try to go with the fold by key. It's very simple. And that's I think I have written here. Here we got 50, 81 and 39. It's very simple. Let's try to see that fold by key. So this is the data. So fold by key of 2 comma lambda x comma y. X plus y. This is what we have written. So this is the data we have here. And this won't be there. Okay. Now can you tell me what should happen with the zero value? Yes, can you tell me 2 comma lambda of x comma x plus y? See this now, what is going to happen? A comma 2 plus 25 plus 30. 2 plus 25 plus 30. So earlier we do not have this 2. Okay, now this 2 plus 25 plus 30 comma b comma 2 plus 26. So that means the zero value will be updated with every key in every partition. Okay, remember that. And next here we have c comma 2 plus 10 plus 10. This is going to happen. And for a 2 plus 10 and I think is it going to be correct actually. One second, let me check here. 12 30 plus 25 55 57 57 plus 12. Correct only. So okay, equal 10. And here what do we get here? A comma 2 plus 10. Next B comma 2 plus 20. Next C comma 2 plus 15. This is what we have to get. We are going to get, okay? So from the first partition, we get the result as a comma 12. The second partition brings result as b comma 22 and c comma 17. Okay, and from the second partition, we are going to get the result as a comma 25 plus 2, 27 plus 30, 57. Right. Next, b as 26 plus 2, 28. And in the third partition, we are going to result as c comma 10, 10, 20, 22. And a comma 12. Okay. This is done internally in each partition. Internally in each partition. Okay. Now the data will be grouped and the same operation will be applied across the partitions. Across the partitions. Okay. Now in a in the first partition we have a 12. So let me go with each partition first. First a. So in the first partition we have 12. In the second partition we have 57. In the third partition we have 12 again. 12. 12. 12. 12. Okay. And this for b. In the first partition we have 22, second partition we have 28. There is no ENC. Next, coming to C. C in the first partition we have 17, second partition we don't have, second, third partition we have 22. Okay. Now here we are going to get the result as something like this. That is, now the all the records will be added now. 12 plus 57 plus 12. That we get as what? A comma. What is that we get? 57 plus 69, 81.
Will the zero value not be added to this?
Yes, that's what I'm coming to this. I will come to that. 22 plus 28, it is 50, right? 50. And c comma 17 plus 22, 39. 81, 50, 39. 81, 50, and 39. Okay, now why the zero value is not updated across the partitions level? But in when we have seen the operations fold and aggregate yesterday, you know, the zero value is getting updated at the partition level as well as at the results of the partition level, right? Across the partitions. Did you remember that, guys? Gurtundadi? The zero value, whatever we have taken, that is getting updated within the partitions as well as across the partitions. But when we are coming to this, what you call as pair oddities, why it is not happening like that? Because, see here, already the key is the zero value, you know, here the intention is we are applying the operation based on the key here. Okay, so this whatever the zero value we are using here, that value is already applied on the unique keys at the partition level. So partition level key is zero value is applied to every key at partition level. Zero value is applied to every key. That is fine. At the results of the, across the partitions, is the key is going to be changed or the keys are going to be different or the same keys will remain? The same keys, right? Here we have A, B, C at the partition level. The same keys will appear across the partitions also. So already the zero value is applied on the keys. Okay. Already the zero value is applied on the keys. So again, applying the zero value on the keys, that is not correct actually. Okay, the thing is, we need to, why we are using zero value, why the zero value is, we have to apply that zero value to every key here. Remember that, guys. Here we are applying that zero value to be applied to every key uniquely, every key.
every key. Okay, so first the key will be up, sorry, zero value will applied only at the partition level. Why? Because the records, the keys or the records are going to be same, the keys are going to be same even across the partitions. Only once the zero value will be applied, it will not be applied across the partitions. It will not be applied across the partitions. So first I'll, let me write that point, that is zero value will be applied only at partition level, only within the partitions, let's say within the partitions, not across the partitions. Okay, see guys, something like this, you know, let's say a company is there. I will explain the use cases in the next. Let me complete all these basics. When we discuss use cases, then we discuss about the, you know, the examples where we have all these. Okay, I will explain all those. But for now, just try to understand here. Let's say that there is a company is there. Company, some XYZ company is there, and it has different branches, various branches in various locations. Let's say it has four locations, and now it has it. The company wants to find out the salary, the maximum salary, or the maximum salary for male and the maximum salary for female. Okay, the maximum salary for male and the maximum salary for female across each branch and overall. Got my point here? The maximum salary for male and the maximum salary for female across at every branch and across all the branches. M comma F. You got my question here? You got my thing here? The company wants to find out the maximum salary or highest salary of male and female at every branch and across the branches. So what you will do? What you will do now? So let's say the maximum salary here we got as, so to find out the maximum salary, we need to have some reference. That is, instead of having maximum salary, I will put like this the question, that is there any male, is there any male or is there any female who is drawing a salary more than 1 lakh, let's say more than 1 lakh per 12 L per year per annum. Okay, so there I will put this 12L as the key there. Okay, not key, sorry, not key. What is it called? A zero value. So I want to find out, is there any male or is there any employee or fair or female who is drawing more than 12 lakhs per annum? Okay, so I will get some result. I will get some, based on this, I will get some result for male and I will get some result for female also. Okay, based on that. Is there or not? If is there, we get some value. Similarly, we get some value for some result at second branch as well as third. For all the branches, we get some result. Now, can you tell me, do you think checking that, so now we got males and male and female result, who is drawing more than 12 or not, whether the males or females are drawing more than 12 lakhs per annum or not, we got the result from each branch. Okay, now what is the next step to do? I want to find out, is there anyone who is getting the salary more than 12 lakhs across the organization, across all the branches. So do we need to apply the 12 lakhs again, or what we have to do? Do we need the 12 lakhs again, that figure? Do we need that figure or not?
No,
not required.
Not required. Already. Why? Because already we have, yes, already that value being applied at partition level, that is branch level, and we got the result. Now only the results are to be compared. Okay, so now we have to compare only the results of each branch, not that figure. Got it?
So we are specifically talking about male and female. So this male is acting as one key, records one key, and female is acting as another key. So this is the reason, this will be the reason why that zero value will not be applied across the partitions. Got it? How the design, how the function is developed, how this fold by key, reduce, how these are developed by this spark is based on this data actually. So as the records are key in values, so some value has to be used, some zero value has to be used only once per key, only once per key at partition level, but not again at the results of the part. That's not required. Because already is applied. The keys will not change across the part. The keys will remain same. So don't do that. That is the reason why the zero value is not applied across the partitions. Is it clear, guys? Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Any question? Yeah, fine. This is very simple. Just is very, very simple. Now, so you can check out with even subtraction, it will work, and we can do. Anyhow, we'll show the examples, use cases after just maybe after tomorrow, or the maybe from Wednesday onwards, we'll start using the use cases. Then I will explain everything. Some examples where we use this, where we don't use this. I will try to explain all those. Okay, fine. The next function is aggregate. It's very simple. Aggregate of zero value, comma, function one, function two, two functions. We need to supply two functions here. So the first function we can pass any function, anyone, and second function we can pass anyone. Right, some S4 equal to RD1 dot aggregate by key. Guys, if it is the first time you are trying to understand this purpose of these functions, and if someone is trying to learn on own, it will take some time to understand. See, it will take some time. Almost when I was first trying to understand this aggregate by key, reduce by key, all this, it took me almost 2 to 3 days to understand this nature of working of this. Okay, so practice. Okay, practice the stuff and try to apply your applications, your requirements, so that you will get the exact idea of how these are working. Okay, practice them.
So, small doubt. Generally, if you are not using RDDs, you are using only data frames, for example, assume. Then, is it possible to apply these features in data frame?
No. We don't have these functions on the data frames.
Okay. We don't have it. Yes.
There we have columns, right? There we don't have key signed values concept there. There we have only columns. There will be
Okay.
some there will be some use cases where we need to handle with RDDs or you know what, data sets. Data, we don't have data sets in Python, but we have them in Scala Spark. There we can use all this again. Okay.
Okay.
Still, data frames vachayi kada, data sets vachayi kada ani, RDs are no longer required. No, that is not true. Remember, RDs are no longer required. Everything has come anedi. No, that's not true. Still, RDs have their own importance and their place in the Spark programming. Remember that. Okay. It's very simple, guys. Here, it just aggregate by key. We need to provide two functions. Sorry, lambda sum a comma b. Can apply some a into b. You can apply any function, guys. A into b, I think it will give larger value. Let's go with a minus b or a by b. But a by b can give some zero value. A by b, what is the issue with a by b, guys? Let's run this. Let's see.
Zero division
Aggregate takes at least four arguments. Three were given. Sorry, we need not give zero value, right? Guys, can you tell me actually how many we are passing here the values? The parameters, arguments.
three.
See that? We did not provide this, right? Okay, we have provided only these two. So we are providing only two, right? Two. One argument is first function, second argument is second function. This is one. If you want, I can put them in braces. So the first argument is the first function, second argument is the second function. But we are trying to execute this. Why it is showing that aggregate by key takes at least four arguments, three given. We gave only two, right? How come it is showing that three were given? Are you able to understand here? Why?
Because period is already is considering x comma y as two. I don't know. That's what I'm saying.
Okay. Then here I will delete this, and I will to perform try to perform this operation. So what is give? What is showing here? Old by key takes at least three arguments. Two given. How many we gave here? Only one, right? Only one integer. Then how come it is saying that two were given? We gave only one there.
One is RDD, sir. Hello.
One is RDD, Vijendra. How come it is RDD? This is a function, right? Whatever we pass inside these braces, that will become the argument, right?
Internal self argument like that in Python.
Perfect. Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Remember that. Every function has an inbuilt argument called as self. In the Python programming, we have seen that SELF self. Do you remember this self? So this is going to be the default argument for these functions. Remember that. What it? So even though we don't specify, that will be internally added to it. That is the reason. It is showing that even though we are not passing it, internally that will be added. So as a, even though you are passing only two, that also will be automatically included in that, because of which it is showing that three were given, need one more. That is the reason, guys. Okay. Now if you give three, along with this three, self will also will be included into that list. So total we have four arguments now. Now it will work fine. So the result B zeros. So we got everything as zero. Then we should delete this remove. So there's a possibility that when we go with this division, there's a possibility of getting zero by division by zero exception. There's a possibility, but here unfortunately we don't have that issue. But do not do this under by B A by B. Suppose if it is some 12 by 3, that's fine. 3 by 12. What is the result here? 3 by 12. Is it going to be correct? Do we get correct result? 12 by 3 and 3 by 12. For 12 by 3, what is that we are going to get?
Yes,
4, right? 3, 4, the 12, right?
Yeah.
And for 3 by 12?
0.
No, we don't get point. We get simply 0.
Okay.
Simply 0. Okay. 0 and 0. If you want to get the remainder percentile 2, okay, use percentile. That will work. Got it? 12 by 3. 12 cannot divide 3. So 12 with 0. 12 into 0, 0. So 3 is going to be the remainder. Okay. And now if we pass 3 by 0. It has to throw an error now. Okay. Integer division or modulo by zero. This is not possible. So when we are performing the division operation, there is a chance that B might become zero for some values. If that becomes zero, it is going to throw this error. Okay. So in that case, you can handle this error by using exception handling. You can write in the programming, but that is not required now. Just try to avoid it. I just now go with the minus or less here. That's fine. So as we have discussed yesterday, the first function will be applied across the party within the partitions or at the partitions level. And the second function will be applied across the partition, the results of the partition. That's very simple. And as it is, the zero value. Okay, got it. So zero value will be applied at the partitions only, not across the partitions. this we will try to understand this. A plus B, A minus B, this is the data of the partitions. Okay, and let me just do this. I think that should be fine. Yeah, fine. 825, E30 we got here. Think better to do this. Fine, we got it. Now here we have Z value, we have taken as 3 here. Z equal to 3. So now we are going to have here in this the first partition. So and F1 equal to, we give this function lambda of x comma y colon x plus y. F2 equal to lambda of a comma b a minus b. And guys, here it need not be always x or y, remember it can be anything, just a temporary variable. Okay, we can use any reference or any variable there, it doesn't matter. Okay, just use like that. A, K, comma B, E, comma B, if you want, you can use your name or anything. Fine, okay. So C5 and A, comma, the value is 3 here. So at the partition level, what is the function that we are trying to apply? First, within the partitions at the partition level, addition will be applied. Next, subtraction will be applied. Okay. So A3, comma 10. And B 2, 3, 20. Direct, I'm writing the value here, 23. And C value will be 3 plus 15, that is going to be 18. Okay. When I will write the value of A directly here, 13. Next, for B here, sorry, A, we are going to get 3 plus 25 plus 30. 28 plus 30, 58. Okay, and for B, what is that we are going to get? 3 plus 26, 29. Okay, and for C here, 3 plus 20, 23. And for A, it is going to be 3 plus 10, 13. Okay, fine. Now, the results of the partitions, the across the partitions, A13 is there. In the second, we have 58. And the third partition we have 13. And for B, in the first partition we have 23. Second partition we have 29. We don't have anything in this third partition. For C, in the first partition we have 18. Second partition we don't have anything, and 23. So finally we will get here. Now the subtraction will be applied here. A comma 13 minus 58. What is the result? 45, right? Minus 45, minus 45, minus 13. Again, it will be minus 58, I think. Next one. B, comma, 23 minus 29. Minus 6. And for C, it is 18 minus 23. Minus 5, right? Minus 58, 6, 5. You can see here, minus 58, minus 6, minus 5. That's it. Very simple, guys. This is how we can deal with this. Okay. So, reduce by key, fold by key, and aggregate by key. Yeah.
Combine by key.
Combine by key, we discuss tomorrow, because it needs almost at least half an hour of time. Okay.
Totally.
Now, before that, you know, I have been telling you that the data will be grouped first within the partitions, and on that again the function will be applied, and again the same steps will be repeated across the partitions, what I am telling. Okay, but internally what happens, there is one more function called as, there will be interview question, guys, compulsory, remember this. there is a function called as group by key. There is a function called as group by key. It won't take anything. It won't take any functions or any arguments. There is a function called as simply group by key. Okay, let me show you that. This is an important iterative question, guys. You will ask iterative is compulsory. So let me just show you what is the purpose of this and how does this behave. Sum s5 equal to rd1 dot group by key. Group by key. It won't take any parameters, okay? It won't take any arguments. Print sy dot collect. Can you see this, guys, here? What's happened here? B comma spark result iterable object of this. Can you see this? What happened here? So BAC. So something is happening with B, that is grouping is happening with B here, as you see here. So we are not writing any mentioning in no function, nothing here. Just we are saying group by key, that's it. Okay. Let's see what is going to happen here. Yeah. This is the one. The first one. First record, B. And the second record with the A as the grouping element. Okay, A as the key. And the next one is C as the key. So what's happening with this? See the second element here. Just second element. Now can I say that it is an ordered pair actually? Otherwise, just see. Print s5, simply s5. We'll see what is the just showing simply right s5 dot I call it as type. Oh, pipeline.dd only, but I have to show the format of actually syntax. Yeah, fine. Let me go with this only. I will tell you one thing before going to this. Okay. Yeah. So what is going to happen here? It is, see this case here. The second element, what is second element we have here? In each, sorry, for each key, something is forming as the its pair element. Something is forming as its pair element. What is it? Something is forming as its pair element. What's happening? What is that?
Values in each.
Okay. Result iterable. You see that? Result iterable. Okay. So I've read this print, not print here, some s6 equal to s5 dot map of lambda x colon. So what is each element, guys, here? What is each record in this s5? What is the type of each record? This is enclosed in braces, right? If it is enclosed in braces, what is it?
List.
Tuple.
Tuple, right? Tuple, okay. So how do we access the first element of the tuple?
Subtree.
Using index.
Index, right? By the index, how do we, right? Just I will show you 1 second. Okay, some A equal to, it is a list, and in that tuple, let's say this time I directly okay 1, 1, 2, 1, 2. This is one tuple, 2, 3. This second tuple, 3, 4. This third tuple. Okay. Now how do I access 1, 2, and 3? The first position elements.
x0, 1.
Yes, right. 0, the first element, otherwise, 1 second, guys, here, write like this. A equal to 1, 2, 3, How to access the first element here? It is simply a of 0. Okay, it is going to be the first element. If it is a of 1, it will be the second element, like that. Okay, that means you can access the particular element of a tuple by using its index. Okay, now in this, every record is a tuple. If you observe here, every record is a tuple. Okay, total we have 3 records corresponding to 3 keys. We have 3 records. Every record is a tuple. How do we access the first element? By using its index 0. Second element by using index as 1. Okay, now lambda x of 0, comma, then do we have count? Okay, x of 1 dot sum. S6 dot print. I think sum is not there. What is showing? Trace back. There's no attribute. Result in trouble. Object no attribute. Sum. Sum manage ledu. One second. Let me try this. There's no attribute max. Result in trouble. Result in trouble. X of 1. Spark result in trouble object at. X1 result iterable in the sense it has to give that, but it's not giving. Invalid syntax. S6.collect. Is one more brace required here? 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. One more required. Yeah. Can you see this, guys? Something is happening here. B26, A30, C15. How come we got this? Am I in here? What do you think that happened here? Max of x of 1.
It's taking the max from the values.
Right? See, what is happening with this group by key is allowed nante, just see is here. So here we have these records, right? Let me just copy those. This is important, guys. Please concentrate just for a while. It's very, very important, this operation. Understand what's happening with this here, okay? So what is going to happen with this is group by key. Group by what it does is it won't do anything. It won't do any aggregation. Just it will group the data. That's it. Just it will group the data. That's it. Nothing. It won't do anything. So it will not do any partition level grouping, or, you know, the group by key will not go with partition level grouping. No, it won't do that. Remember, guys, here. So in interview, they will ask one question. What is that? What is the difference between group by key and reduce by key? So see here, guys, here, where do we have reduce by key? Ikkada undi reduce by key undi kada. here we have this one. What is the result? S1, right? So if I print S1 and if I print this, I'm going to get the same result. See here now. Just see here, I'm printing this and I'm printing S1 dot collect. Will the result be same or different? Just try to see here. Same or different? Do you get the same result here?
Yes.
Okay. Then if we could achieve the same thing, and what is that we are doing actually? M out in the reduce by kilo. In reduce by kilo, the data is getting grouped and on that sum is happening, right? Express where we are doing that. Okay. We are able to achieve the same thing with group by key, but the difference is, remember, group by key will not go with partition level grouping. No, it won't do that. It will do the grouping across the partition, totally entire the entire data. Okay, the entire data. Okay, so it won't do that directly. It will create like this: a comma 10, 25. And 30 and B 26 and then next to C 10 25 30. I think it is one more we have right here. Go to the other 10 and 9. See, we have how many? 15, 10 and 10. We have only these. Okay, now see this, guys. This is what ikkada kanipistunda, just chudandi. This is what, whatever that is ikkada form ayin chusara, 10 25 30 15. This is formed as what? Iterable result, iterable object. Inda manam chusam kada iterable object anokati ikkada, sorry, we have seen that iterable of Python, iterable result, iterable anoka, we have seen as an object. Can you see this now? Result iterable object and chepesi. Okay, this is going to be that result iterable. Ikkada form ayinda that we are not able to see, but this is what the result iterable is forming there. Okay, and 1026, this is going to be the second iterable object that is forming there. Okay, and this is the third iterable object that is forming there. Okay, and what is that I am writing function here? See this, some result equal to this rd dot map of ila rastunna nenu lambda x colon rasanu x of 0. What do you mean by x of 0 here? You put three records low. What is x of 0? The first element, right? A, B and C. And second, what I am writing it is sum of x of 1. What does it mean? X of 1 and this is the entire iterable object. The entire iterable object. Then paina, what is that I am doing? Sum. Sum in the sense, all the values whatever we have in this iterable object, they will be summed up. Okay. Let me show you that. Let me show you a simple example. Now I write sum x equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. I write sum of x. How come we got sum of x here? What is x here now? What is x? X is a tuple, right? X is a tuple. It is an iterable object. The elements in that object can be iterable. So I can apply directly sum on x. Exactly that I did here. So on this iterable object, I have performed sum of x of 1. X of 1 in the sense, every list here. Not list, sorry. What is it? Tuple. So we got the sum corresponding to that. That's it, very simple. See the function here, sum of x comma 1. If I want to get the maximum element, what can I do? I can use max. So like I can use max here, max of x. What is the result I have to get? 4. Here I have to get 4. So in this, it has, we have to get the sum of maximum from each iterable. So from a equal to, for a we have to get 30. For B, we have to get 26, and for C, we have to get 10, not 10, sorry, 15. Okay, that is how it is going to work, guys. Let me print this once. But this is okay, programmatically this is fine, but internally how it is executing differently. But internally how it is executing differently, see this case here. Now can you tell me, we are able to achieve the same result with group by key and reduce by key, the addition, okay? Now which one you prefer, whether group by key or reduce by key?
Sir, can I ask one thing?
Yeah, please. Yeah.
My point of view, group by key is better, because group by key is not, see, for example, reduce by key, it is doing partition level, and again all the remaining partition data has to move to any one of the partition, again the grouping will be done, and again the reduce by key will apply. But here we are skipping one level, right? Group by key.
Yes.
Yeah, that's why the group by key is the best.
Yeah. Any other answers, guys? I'm telling you, there will not be any partition level grouping in the group by key operation, but we can achieve same thing. We are able to see, we got the same result. So which one do you think, which one would be, which gives the better performance?
Because shuffling is doesn't happen between the partition.
No, first question, which function, whether group by key or reduce by key, which function will involve shuffling?
Both.
Right.
Both, exactly. Perfect. Perfect. Both involve shuffling. But which involves both shuffling, you know, cost, the which is we costly, which is very costly, actually costly.
Reduce
by key is simple compared to group by key. Reduce by key is cheaper. Why? Because it is grouping some, you know, it is doing half of the work, almost half of the work within the partition only. You know, grouping and applying the function is happening in the partitions, and after that again on the results of the partitions. But group by key is not doing anything in the partition level. At the partition level, it is not doing anything. It is a partition level. It is directly grouping all the data first, and it is doing grouping and applying the function on that. So see here, guys, here now here totally we have how many records we have here? 9 records, right? In all the three partitions we have totally 9 records. So if we use group by key, totally all the records will be shuffled, all the records will move from one partition to the partition, okay? Yes. Why? Because it doesn't any partition level grouping. But when we go with group reduce by key here, when we go with reduce by key in this case, from each partition, now tell me, this is reduced by key. In this, from the first partition, how many records are grouped? How many records are shuffled? Three records are shuffled. And from the second partition, how many records are shuffled?
Two
parties, two. And from third partition, how many records are shuffled? Only two parties, sorry, two records. Okay, that means, as the data is getting grouped by the keys here, the number of records that will be shuffled across the network when we're trying to perform the partition grouping across the partition will be less. Okay, compulsorily less than that of the total number of partitions, total number of records. Okay, but group by key, you know, here we have 9 records are there, so it will perform all the 9 records. All the 9 records will be shuffled. But in case of reduced by key, that will not happen. Only the records that are output of the partitions will be shuffled, not all the records.
But it skipped one level, right? That's
exactly. Skipping one level, yeah. Whatever the answer you give is exactly correct. It's correct. It's perfect. But way of putting is different, that's it.
Yeah.
The way you have put the answer is different, but it is correct, 100% correct. So remember that group by key is a costly operation compared to reduce by key operation. Why? Because it doesn't involve partition level grouping. Okay, it is very simple, guys. Suppose if I have 5 friends, if I have 5 friends with me, and I give everyone some 200 currency notes to count. Okay, I have 1000 currency notes with me. I give five of my friends 200. To each everyone 200, so they will do the count, and how many figures they are going to give me as the result? They have counted 200 currency notes, and how many they are going to give me? What is the result they are going to give me? Let's say 50,000. One guy is giving, one friend is giving 50,000, only one figure. 50,000, that's it. Okay, another guy is giving, let's say, five friends, F1, F2, F3, F5. So each guy is allotted some 200 currency notes. You gave like this. Totally, you have actually 1,000 currency notes with you, but you do not want to take the burden. So you get 200 currency notes. So instead of counting 1,000 currency notes, instead of counting 1,000 currency notes or 1,000 values, 1,000 values, finally, how many values you will count? So let's say that F1 has gave the figure as some 10,000. That is, then I have counted 200 currency notes. The sum value is 10,000. And he gave the result as 10,000. And someone gave the result as 5,000. And third friend gave the result as some 10,000 again. And fourth friend gave the result as some only 2,000. The 200 currency notes under 2,000 of Sada. Is there a chance, right? 10 rupees and Rajka. Next, let's say some 10,000 again. Now, suppose if you do not have these friends, me friends, Leran Kondi, how many currency, how many values you have to count? How many values? I'm asking how many values? Values and 10. 1,000 exactly. Oka currency note ko value kada. Each currency note gives one value, right? 10 plus 10 plus 10. So every currency note is giving a value. But I have assigned that work to all the five friends. But now, after they gave the result to me, how many values I'm counting now?
Five.
Only five. Only five, right? 10,000, 5,000, 10,000, 2,000, 5,000. Now the work on me is very, very, very less. You know, instead of counting 5,000, now I'm counting only five. Only five. See how effective this operation is doing. You know, delegating the work to other people and getting only the result, getting their computer result. I'm working on only the computer result. Okay. So this is going to decrease a lot of burden on me. Likewise, this reduce by key, fold by key, aggregate by key are working. But group by key, you know, it is not delegating work to anyone. No, it is not delegating work to anyone. It is doing everything. It is bringing everything. It is trying to do the work. So when we have large amounts of data, group by key will be very, very costly operation. Do not go with group by key when we have large amounts of data. This is not recommended. Okay, instead go with reduce by key or any other operations. Is it clear, guys?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Perfect, guys. Okay. So in the next session, tomorrow we shall try to understand combined by key as well. We have some operations called as set operations, ACET set. Okay, we shall try to understand, and if possible, we shall try to see the checkpointing concept also tomorrow. That be done, and what is the meaning of it and how we can implement that. Clear, okay. Please?
Yeah, clear.
Fine. Thank you. If you have any questions, please let me know. Otherwise, we shall wind up the session for today.
One thing, so slice is like RDD operation or the data frame?
What?
Slice. Like split.
Slice. RDD?
Is it RDD operation or data frame?
Slicing.
Slicing.
I think that works on both, I think.
Okay.
Let me check.
Sir, yeah, one please. Session, can you, if you don't mind, one session, can you please cover me? What are the common operations in both RDD or data frame? Like that, is there any
common operations?
Is there any common?
Okay, there are certain common operations are there. Yeah, yeah.